Museum, a universal museum in the Arab world. Located in Abu Dhabi, Louvre is a new cultural beacon bringing different cultures together to shine fresh light on the shared stories of humanity. The origins of Louvre Abu Dhabi date back to March 2007. The UAE and France formed an unprecedented partnership for cultural exchange, and the highlight of this will be the establishment of Louvre Abu Dhabi on Saadiyat Island. The partnership would combine the UAE's bold vision of cultural progression and openness with France's expertise in the world of art and museum. Explore the shared themes that reveal and connect humanity with Dr. Stephen Akintayo on this episode of Learning Luxury Show.
And of course, we're going to be checking a very wonderful museum here in Abu Dhabi. It's my first time coming back to Abu Dhabi after 3 solid years, and I'm excited to visit almost everywhere visitable. So join me and enjoy this wonderful episode of Learning Luxury live from Abu Dhabi. It's one of the most expensive museums in the world in terms of construction cost, the beauty, the luxury, and as you can see, it's an island, you know, with blue sea waters. If you just check right there, you have the beautiful sea waters. It's built on an island, and you know, artificial island actually. One of the best anywhere in the world.
Naira, that's it. Oh yes. I just got the alert. Congratulations on becoming a landlord. It's nice doing business with you.
Daddy?
Yes, darling?
How do you make so much money? You're always calling millions on the phone.
I make sacrifices.
Sacrifice? What type of sacrifice?
When you give up something of value for the sake and consideration of other things, that's a sacrifice. I invested in real estate when the opportunity came, even when it was not convenient. And that's a success story we're reaping today.
Wow, wow. Awesome.
You don't wait to buy real estate. You buy and wait.
Take advantage of this amazing opportunity today.
GTEX Homes. We help you build your future.
Yes, now I'm dressed properly.
Normally you would have to do it in like, not like, but in a triangle.
Okay. This way.
Okay, so we'll get the triangle.
Oh, nice.
And once you make the triangle.
Yes.
And you iron it with an ironer.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, we in the Gulf, having little differences between one country to another.
Yes.
But the people there in up north of in the Gulf and Kuwait,
yeah,
they reverse the triangle. I don't know why they reverse it, but...
Okay.
Yeah, no. Still, if you reverse a triangle, it's still a triangle.
Yeah. Yeah.
But it will differentiate.
Yeah, it's more of, it's similar.
Who's in the right direction and who's in the right direction.
Yeah.
So unfortunately, because we'll surely, you'll go and iron this later.
Okay.
Now we cannot have the triangle.
Yeah.
So we'll imagine that you are having a triangle.
Okay.
So I iron it with straight.
Now you will have to choose, okay, I like drama.
Wow. Mm.
You'll have to choose either to look like a sheik.
Yeah, sheik? Sheik, of course,
king.
Sheik.
Prince or a king, still there
king.
Is two big options here.
King.
Okay, king. That means very formal word, that, yeah.
Yeah.
Because, actually, they all look the same, but I'm just making up this one.
Okay.
So to
can I remove this?
Yes, you'll have to remove it. We, the men, we don't like, you know, trademarks and these.
Yes.
I bought this from Dolce & Gabbana, I bought it from, no, 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 we don't like that.
Yeah.
The other side of humanity, they like, yeah.
Yes, women love to do
yes.
That.
Okay. Some more. Mm. As you can see, I don't have that one.
Okay.
This is something, it used to be the sheikhs who like this one.
Okay.
As you say that I'm wearing something, but that's an old thing. Nowadays, they all wear the same.
Okay.
So what did you say you want to be, the king, the prince, or the sheikh?
King.
The king, it must be very formal.
What's the difference between the sheikh and the king?
I'm just making it up. I told you I like a drama, but you know, normally really high people will look very formal.
Yeah.
Extremely formal. But a guy like me, I will, you know, because I try to look young. Why I look young? Because I'm only 15.
I can't
so I'll do something like this.
Or okay.
Do something like...
Oh.
You know, something like make me...
Yeah.
But...
Makes it look stylish.
Yes.
So this is how I'm going to look.
Yeah. No, you should not do this.
Okay.
This is
I'm the sheikh.
This is not the Far East. This is the Middle East.
Yeah.
Okay. You start from...
Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, the whole, these what we call the permanent galleries, they are divided into four wings.
Okay.
And then every wing is divided into three chapters.
Okay.
So the total is 12 and four wings.
Okay.
And they will be going into a chronic or chronological order.
Okay.
From the oldest one, which is chapter 1, chapter 2, 3, or wing 1, wing 2, wing 3, wing 4.
Okay.
To the latest one in here. We are exhibiting an artwork which is only 2 years old.
Okay.
But here, I think this is 20,000 years old. Mm. And if we go to the introduction, you know, I said an introduction is always good.
Yeah.
That's what we call it, the Grand Vestibule.
Okay.
And the Grand Vestibule is just like a lobby of a hotel.
Okay.
Where people will be welcome.
Yeah.
And then you will see examples of the artwork that you may see repeated.
Okay.
In the next 12 chapters or four.
Yeah, like this was repeated, the axe
was there. And the idea is always here to show our two concepts here. The first concept is universality, and the second concept or our method or our mean of presenting that universality is by comparison. Now, why universality? Because look, Abu Dhabi is a universal museum. Why they decided to have a universal museum? A simple answer is, we have 30 local museums, other local museums.
Wow.
So it's a museum for all,
either
for the residents who are having like 198 nationalities here, or for the tourists and the guests and everyone else. Everyone comes to here will find an artwork, if not from his country or her country,
or from their region,
their culture or their civilization, or their region. Something that they will feel close to. And why they brought the Louvre? Because the Louvre also a universal museum. Not like this one started 500 or 600 years ago. It started as a French art academy. And then as a, just a European
museum. Why the French?
Yes.
Why choose the French?
Okay, because we also going to have an American one, the Guggenheim. And if we can, we can bring a British one. Because, you know, it's the amount of experience and reputation with those museums, Well, first save you a lot, and second thing, they have big collections of international artworks.
Mm.
To start from scratch and build a collection of artworks that cover 10,000 years of art is not an easy job.
True, very true.
But anyway, this one is not like a branch or a copy paste, copy or a version from the one in France.
Mm-hmm.
No, not at all.
Okay.
Here it's run by the Department of Culture and Tourism in Abu Dhabi.
Okay.
And only the names is Louvre.
Okay.
And then the way the narrative goes from here is you start from the most ancient one and you go to the most recent one.
Recent one.
But if you go to the Louvre of Paris, it's divided into different departments.
Yeah.
The European art, the Asian art, the African art, the Middle East.
Yeah.
The Chinese, etc.
Yeah.
You don't see any connection between them. You can't even visit them again and again and again, or you just visit one department at a time and that's it.
Mm-hmm.
But here, if you start from chapter one, you have to finish chapter 12.
Wow.
Otherwise, you will lose
this narrative. Okay.
And I think, if I'm not mistaken, this is maybe the only museum, the Universal Museum here in the Middle East.
Wow.
Yes.
In the whole of Middle East.
Universal, yes.
Wow.
Because all the other ones are either regional or local museum.
Okay.
Even if you go to the big museums in Egypt, we have vast museums.
Wow.
They are all about the ancient civilization, the Egyptian civilization.
Yeah.
You'll never find something there coming from Asia or from Europe.
Wow.
Now, what can I say in here about the introduction?
Mm.
Every cabinet has a universal idea.
Yeah.
And for every universal idea, we have three examples.
Mm.
Only three examples, we could have 10 from different parts of the world to prove to the world and to the visitor that we, the humans, we share a lot of things in common.
Mm.
I will take only two examples, one from
the motherhood.
One to define the idea of what is the purpose of art, and one to define what is an artwork.
Mm.
So let's take this one, the most simplest one.
Mm.
This project, by the way, has costed billions.
Wow.
And many people, when they come to here, they say, you are exhibiting stones. Yes, because these stones are defining the idea of what an artwork is.
Mm-hmm.
Let me show you this one.
Mm.
This one from Algeria, that's Africa.
Mm.
This one from Saudi Arabia, that's Asia.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one from France, Europe.
Mm.
500,000 years old.
Wow. Wow.
There was no communication between them, but yet they reached all similar shapes.
Yeah, there is.
Why? How come? Because maybe they were copying nature, the shape of the tree leaves.
Mm-hmm.
If you want it more romantic, you may see
love.
The water drops. That's very
okay,
romantic.
That's
I don't
true.
Think the Asian.
It also looks like love if you turn it the
you
other way.
The heart.
Yes, the heart that symbolizes love.
Those people 500,000 years ago, I don't think they were.
They didn't know
I think
the picture
they,
of
they barely could speak at that time.
Yes,
And the other thing is, you see the symmetry here. And symmetry could be the most basic aesthetic element here.
Mm-hmm.
So from that very ancient time, 500,000 years ago.
Hmm.
They thought of the most basic element of design.
Mm.
And from that time, humans are no longer part of the animal kingdom. We are not only the Homo erectus or the Homo sapiens, we are the Homo artifex or the Homo fever, the artist.
Mm.
So an artwork is a daily object that was made so fine that stopped functioning its original function, which is just like a tool.
Mm-hmm.
A stone axe
that
became an artwork. And you will start seeing this one for weapons like swords, books, manuscripts. Even if we go outside now, you see so many decoration over the building.
Mm-hmm.
What is the function of those, that decoration?
Mm-hmm.
Just to decorate.
Mm-hmm.
They have nothing to do about the space or about how many people there or about the function of that building.
Yeah.
No, you just decorate it.
That's the title there, for maternity. One from Congo, for Zaire, one from ancient Egypt, and one from Europe.
Mm-hmm.
And they are all mothers with kids or with feeding kids.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you look at this one from Zaire or Congo, it's called the Fimba.
Mm-hmm. The Fimba.
Fimba, with P-H-E-M, Fimba.
Mm-hmm.
And the Fimba is a deity for fertility.
Mm-hmm.
Now, those people are not people living in the forest. No, those are farmers. Somewhere maybe from north of Congo, I'm not sure from which area exactly, but those were farmers. And look where she's putting her hand, the right one.
Mm.
That's a jar of cereals, as if she's giving the blessing, or she's the one giving the humans the blessing.
Mm.
You know, in all the cultures of the world, the ancient one, they took the mothers as simple fertility.
Mm.
Because they saw them making life,
yeah.
and they saw earth or the land mm. also giving life
mm.
and giving crops and giving food.
Mm.
So they are taking here motherhood for an economic purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Food. We go to the one in the middle, that's Isis and her son Horus.
Mm.
All Egyptian kings, ancient Egyptian kings, they claim to be descended from heaven, specifically from that Horus, young boy there,
mm.
and his mother Isis. Now, every king, just like us nowadays,
mm.
we'll be hanging the pictures or the photos of our grandfather
mm.
or our father, we'll say,
mm.
I came from those.
Yeah.
So the ancient Egyptian king, they taken motherhood not for a economic
mm-hmm.
purpose, but mm-hmm. for a political purpose, supporting their right, their divine right to rule over Egypt, because
wow.
they are descended from gods.
Wow.
So that's politics, that's economy, and that's
religion.
That's religion, or that's religious one,
mm-hmm.
the Virgin and the Holy Child who came for the salvation
mm-hmm.
of humanity.
Mm-hmm.
So you see, one artwork is serving religion,
mm-hmm.
one is serving politics,
mm-hmm.
one is serving
economy,
the market, the state, the temple, the church, or the mosque. Art will enslave itself for 10,000 years to come.
Wow.
Because how will artists live? You know, in the old days, you cannot go and open a shop and put your painting. Please, can you buy my paintings?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Or that sculptor who was making that big statue for Ramses,
mm-hmm.
if an Egyptian
yeah.
thing, it was taking 3-5 years to finish the sculpture.
Mm.
How is he going to make a living?
Wow.
He had to serve a king, serve a prince.
Mm.
Or Michelangelo, who was telling the poems by creating
yeah.
the churches for them.
Yeah.
Or other writers. Or now, many people they think have to start serving either the state
mm-hmm.
or the religion first,
mm-hmm.
but actually start to with economy.
Mm. Wow.
Although this one is political side,
yeah.
that's one is the market, and that's one is religious statues
yeah.
or deities, but
yeah,
they are
absolutely.
All about economy.
Yeah.
These are again motherhood of deities, the
mm-hmm.
deities of fertility.
Mm-hmm.
And fertility, we said that's economic.
Yeah.
These were made and exported to different countries.
Yeah.
The ceramic.
Yeah.
That's economy.
Economic.
Those are the daggers,
yes.
which were made from jade,
yeah.
and they were to distinguish the leader, the chief men,
mm.
from the others.
Okay.
And they are like 5, 6, 7,000 years old.
Wow.
And even this one, which is about 18,000 years, it's made from stone.
This one.
This way. But look how sharp it is. I bet it will cut even a hand.
True.
And if they have used it, it would have been break, it would have get broken because it's so sharp and so thin.
Mm.
So why did they make it?
Mm.
They wanted to show that, look, I have a dagger that's so sharp and so finely made.
Mm-hmm.
All, I will make it from jade stone, jade
mm.
stone, toward the gold of the Neolithic age or
mm.
the Stone Age.
Mm.
And all of those were the chief men of the farmers
mm.
because they wanted to distinguish themselves
from
their followers or from their subject. So
yeah.
this is politics, that's religion again.
Yes.
Everything here is about economy. This one was made in south of Iraq, but it was exported to here, UAE,
yeah.
1,000 miles away.
Wow.
And how old? 7,500 years ago. That's 5,500 BC.
Wow.
Before the invention of writings, before the building of big temples, and before the invention even of state,
wow.
trade and the traders and the business people were sailing across the seas
wow.
to deliver their goods.
Interesting.
Thanks to capitalism. Without capitalism, we would not have had civilization.
Mm-hmm.
I have no problem with capitalism, and I'm no friend of socialism.
Mm-hmm. So which are you? Who do you support?
Me?
Yeah.
I'll support
life.
Oh, other things just to be said. Oh, it depends on what age I could live.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, those leaders who were only chief men,
yeah.
they get more and more people around them, and
yeah.
those small
yes.
villages grow to be big cities
yeah.
and big kingdoms. the first great power or the first kingdom in the world. Mm. From ancient Egypt, to ancient Iraq, to ancient India, and ancient China. Who could stop Ramses II, the great general of Egypt, or kingdom, if he decided to invade all of Africa with 5,000 soldiers enough? That's it. So they were a great power. And his ancestors, because they are now building kingdoms which stretch over big rivers like Nile, now they needed ways of communication, so they built writing, and they needed to count.
Wow.
Yep.
So writing started with Egypt.
Here. It could have also started in Iraq or Mesopotamia, just a century or 2 centuries earlier. Mm-hmm. Because also there they were making small states. Mm-hmm. They called them the city states. Mm. That's what the reason. If you need to take the last tour, this one, which is 24 writings. Mm-hmm. So the writings were written. Yes, 24 writings.
Looks like an exergy to me.
The columns on the
road? Yes.
What is exergy but something like this? And they were counting, huh?
So how are they able to write this on the stone? And so
we had a different example before, which was showing really two rows mm-hmm. and four columns mm-hmm. of things. Mm-hmm. Types and quantity. Types and quantity. What mm-hmm. is Excel sheet but something?
Exactly. Yeah? Exactly.
I started here. Big kingdoms. And here they consider themselves to be, the mediators between heaven and the people. Hmm. Will you vote for me next time, please?
Wow.
That guy, he doesn't care about voting.
Yes.
He earned it by the blood right. Hmm. He's descended from Ra. Ra has made him. Ramses. That's his name. So why this one was only a prince, a mediator between heaven or the gods or the deities and the subject, and why that one was a god or the son of God?
This is Iraq.
Yes, that's Egypt.
That's Egypt.
Although they made from the same stone, granite, or they call it diorite, the black granite, but the size, well, they say.
What religion were they practicing here?
Well, he had seven statues of him in all the eight statues of him in all the eight temples in his city. So that means there was like eight different deities there.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh. And he wanted to show himself beside the deities.
Oh, okay.
Now what happened, let me put it in this dramatic way. Mm. In ancient Egypt, if we talk before the emergence of the state and the emergence of the dynasties, which happened around 1,200 years ago, before that, who were the scientists? The priests.
Mm.
Because they had more free time than the farmers and the others, and they kept keeping records of the river floods and when it comes, when it goes. Mm. And they found out that it almost happens in the same month, in the same week of the year, the flood comes and the flood withdraws in the same week of the month. Mm. So they found it like in nowadays, May and September. Mm. And they took that piece of this information, the discovery, and they came to our big ruler at that time, they told him, look, if you make us more powerful and you give us a lot of tax, like religious tax, temple tax, or whatever, we can tell you about the date, almost the exact date, that the flood will come, and then you can claim to your subject that you spoke to your dad and you brought the flood, and you will ask him to go back 4 months later.
Wow.
Something like this happened. And that's why they will always make offering for the river in May, and they will make another offering in September. That's before the construction of the high dam on the river Nile in 1950s or 1960s. Now there is no flood in Egypt anymore for the last 60 years. Sure. And since he was controlling or claimed to be, to control the flood, so he can be son of God. But this guy and his ancestors, it was a very big problem. There is two big rivers in Iraq. There is only one there.
Wow.
And these two rivers will have a flood in winter and in summer. Two flood seasons. Crazy. How can you control it? How can you claim to control it? How can you anticipate in ancient Iraq, even until now, when the flood will come? It's hard. Although those were the one who invented writing first, they invented math, they even invented astronomy.
Mm.
Yeah, they are the one who divided the clock into 12 hours and the days and the weeks. And
wow.
Weeks. They were the one. But wow. To anticipate when the flood will come, mm. it was hard for them. So the maximum they could claim to be the mediator
mm.
between heaven and earth.
Wow.
That guy? No. Mm.
Yeah. He's powerful.
Well, there's a lot to be said in that.
Yeah.
So this is sometimes a history of what the Bronze Age. Because mm-hmm. mostly tools and things were made from bronze.
Mm-hmm.
However, later on, when the ceramic kilns became bigger
mm-hmm.
and higher temperature was coming out of those kilns,
mm-hmm.
the iron started to melt. And they discovered the iron stone the same way they discovered the copper stones mm-hmm. or the bronze there.
Mm-hmm.
Only around the ceramic kilns.
Mm-hmm.
Only there. And now they discovered the iron and they domesticated the horse and the camels.
Mm-hmm.
So instead of smoking them, they had empires.
Wow.
The Asian empires started from the Persians around the 6th century before the Christ.
Mm.
Later on, the Macedonians, the Romans, and the Huns of China, and all the other ones.
Mm.
Unlike this one here, it's one of our masterpieces. You cannot see anyone in its size from that time, which is they call it the Warring Kingdoms, 4 centuries before the Christ,
mm.
and it's made from bronze. I mean, that size. This is the biggest.
Wow.
But the way we distinguish the leader of the emirate from the other members of his family is he's called the ruler sheikh.
Oh,
Because he's ruling the emirate. Yes.
The ruling sheikh.
And the ruler of Abu Dhabi, which is the capital, is
yeah.
called also the ruler of Abu Dhabi, but also he's the president of the country.
Of the country.
And 7 of them, and every 5 years they meet every year.
Oh, okay.
During the celebration of the Independence Day, 2nd
okay.
of December.
Okay.
But every 5 years they will re-elect, or they will elect a new one.
Okay.
But so far it has been
the same person.
Yeah, the person from Abu Dhabi. Yes.
Yeah.
It's the biggest one.
Yeah.
And we like our president.
Interesting.
This couple, they are playing chess. And what is the result here? Checkmate. Are you sure? 2 kings.
Mm.
If 2 kings, that means
checkmate.
And then that checkmate. You can make checkmate, but not with a king, because a king cannot kill a king. Because the only distance between them is 1 square.
Mm-hmm.
If any one of them approaches,
mm.
the other one will kill it.
Mm-hmm.
So that means. And all of the other stones were already
so
removed.
Stalemate.
Yes, so they are tied, or they are equal.
Okay.
And chess is a game of mind, or
mm.
brain.
Mm.
So if they are equal now
mm-hmm.
in this, so they must be equal in rights and obligations.
Mm.
And look in here, as if she's gained a new power.
Mm.
And he gets surprised. What just happened here? See, he's standing. This is the first time. Normally I will. Look at her size comparing to his size. He's standing and he's almost in her height. What is happening? This is 1769.
Wow.
This is 150 years before the first woman movement in England. And the artists are observing these new ideas from philosophers like Jean-Jacques Rousseau, Voltaire, Montesquieu, all these philosophers. And they presented it in art. And we cannot claim that those aristocratic couple, they didn't realize the idea that was going on there in their art. No, they knew.
Mm.
Yeah, because they were educated in art and everything.
Mm.
So this is the age of illumination, the 1800s. Sorry, the 1700s.
Yeah.
you. I appreciate it. I love the beautiful colors. You guys are. You guys are fantastic.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Love having
you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Don't
know
what.
When we say shagotam, welcome, you say thank you. It means don't know what.
Don't know what.
Don't know what.
D-H-O-N-N-O-B-A-D.
Don't know
what?
No? Don't
know
what?
Yeah!
Now, once they had these two most beautiful art schools, Impressionism and the other side, Orientalism, which was also triggered by the photograph that was coming from the East, called Orientalism. Then art got more and more liberated here. And imagine what triggered things like abstraction. The artists here at the beginning of the 20th century, they were looking for a new, let's call it art stimulation. They wanted to destroy the old art because all those standards were inherited, you know, from royalty and the aristocracy. They wanted something new, and to start from scratch is very hard. So they were influenced by this art. This is one of the sources of influence to them or inspiration. This artwork that was coming from the Polynesian islands, from Africa, from the Pacific Indian artworks, and looking here. Look at this art. Which one is more of this art? This or that? At least, when you look in here, this was created by an artist who was a farmer. Sorry. Look, it's symmetrical, but also he made sure to put the eyes in non-symmetrical position, just to add, you know, a touch of non-symmetry. But look how he could balance, or she could balance her artwork. It's going in an arc of like 50 centimeter there, but it's still balanced in like 10 centimeter of a base. The European artists were touched by something like this, something like that. And what did this one? So static looking, but so dynamic in meaning. That's a snake swallowing its prey, and the prey is going into the stomach. Mm-hmm. Can you see what's happening here? Mm-hmm. The dynamism in here? Mm-hmm. And this is the result. Cubism. Oh, God help me. Join the cubism.
Interesting.
Now, Abu Dhabi has been here for about 100 years. Abu Dhabi has been here for about 2 or 3 years. Other artists that came from abstract surrealism, romanticism, you see, they put them in one, and they put this one. That one from your neighbor, the fiber coast. And again, you can still see the same art.
Yes.
Masculism and humanism.
Wow.
Honestly, even if I bring kids, that one. Mm-hmm. There is something wrong with the artist's mind. But anyway, what is surrealism is all about? It's going to go out of realism. That's why it's called surrealism. So we are here in the 20th century. What's happening outside here in the joint and what's happening inside there.
Wow.
Susan Fritscher, she's a Swiss. Okay, hold this.
Austrian artist.
Mm-hmm. I like my partner here, he always helps me. Thank you. She's an Austrian artist and she likes to play with the what they call the light illusion here. She had made many like this before, and one of them was presented in France in 2017 inside the George Pompidou Art Center for Modern Art. And our people here, they liked it. They invited her to come and make similar artwork that is inspired by the structure here or by the museum. And she covered these forms, these geometric forms from the dome, and she connected these circulars in to allow the light that's coming from the sky room to reflect in here and play its own and play with its own harp. Many people, when they look at it, they feel either the water is falling or either they are flying in the air. But what this kind of installation is giving you the chance for is that the other artworks, you are looking at them in a very passive way.
Mm-hmm.
Or even if you go around them, you cannot feel yourself joining.
Mm-hmm.
Or one part of the artwork.
Mm-hmm.
But here, no, it's giving you the chance to immerse yourself inside the artwork and be you and the artwork in one part. Now, if you want to go there and walk through it, it's like a maze, but these dots are showing you the path. You can go either the right side or the left side, and this is the best time for him to be filmed.
Oh.
Yeah. Don't get lost, please. Yeah, follow the dots. He's called the ruler Sheikh. That's it, because he's ruling the emirate.
Yes.
And the ruler of Abu Dhabi, which is the capital, is called also the ruler of Abu Dhabi, and also he's the president of the country. And seven of them, and every 5 years, they make every year. During the celebration of the independent state, 2nd of December. But every 5 years, they will re-elect, or they will elect new one, but so far it has been the same. The person from Abu Dhabi, yes, it's the biggest one.
Yeah.
And we like our company.